Selection began today in the George Huguely murder trial. The University of Virginia
lacrosse player is accused of killing his
ex-girlfriend, Yeardley Love of Cockeysville.
She also was a UVA women's lacrosse player.
The 11 News reporter Lowell Melzer has been following the day's events in court. Joins us now live from Charlottesville, Virginia with the very latest. Lowell?
Yes, Stan and Donna, day one began at 9:30 this morning with George Huguely looking clean-cut, dressed in a suit, as he pled not guilty to the six charges that he is facing in this case, including murder. Now, not much action otherwise, as jury selection, which also began today, is taking much longer than was expected. Monday morning, just before 8:30, the family of Yeardley Love is escorted through a back door of the Charlottesville Circuit Courthouse. George Huguely's father quickly walks past cameras in the front. After spending almost 2 years in jail, Huguely will now face a jury of his peers who will decide if he was responsible for his ex-girlfriend Yeardley Love's death. According to court documents, Love was found in her off-campus apartment on May 3, 2010, in a pool of her own blood by a roommate who originally called 911 because she thought Love was having an alcohol overdose. But paramedics found evidence of physical trauma. Day one of Huguely's murder trial was strictly devoted to jury selection in what became a long and tedious process. According to court officials, of the more than 160 potential jurors to be questioned, the Commonwealth of Virginia and the defense will cut the field down to 25. Each side will then get six strikes, narrowing the jury to 12 with three alternates. Throughout the day, the judge, Commonwealth, and defense attorneys polled jurors. Some of the more popular questions concerned whether a juror would be able to find Huguely innocent or guilty, if they had reservations about reasonable doubt, if they had problems looking at extremely graphic photos, and if they had already formed an opinion because of media coverage or someone they knew close to the case. By day's end, both families and those close to them left the courthouse with no comment for reporters, as the judge in the case has issued a gag order until a verdict is reached. Now, to update you, so far only 9 of those 27 potential jurors have been chosen at this point. And to recap from that, each side will get to strike 6 to have a jury of 12 with 3 alternates. Now, because this process is taking so long, the judge is extending court hours until 8 o'clock this evening, and then we'll join a half hour earlier tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. For now, we're live in Charlottesville, Virginia. I'm Lowell Melzer, WBAL-TV 11 News.